Hey, all you truth seekers, good to see you. I wanted to talk to you about something that's come up a couple of times in my conversations with people this week, and even in my conversations with myself. As is often the case, my work inspires me and teaches me and helps me grow. And as you know, the last couple of weeks, the big topic has been having faith and keeping faith despite what you see. The old quote, walking by faith and not by sight, and exactly what that means, how to make that concept have the rubber hit the road, right? So this week, I really wanted to share another concept with you, and that is where you seek your information. As we go throughout our day, our five physical senses, and even our sixth sense, picks up information all the time. You know, we see things, we hear things, we smell things, we touch things, and then we also sense things. And sometimes our emotional antenna can actually interrupt that sixth sense, and we get what we think is a sense of something, an instinct about something, and it's actually an incorrect sense. So it's important, I think, as you go forward in your progress, to slowly shut down those five senses in terms of how significant and how impactful they are for you. You can still, of course, see the beautiful trees and flowers and see the bird flying in the air, and you can hear children laughing, and you can feel the hug from a loved one, and all of those wonderful things that you do get from your physical senses. But when they try to tell you that it's significant and it will impact you, it's going to touch you in any way, bad or good, be wary. Be on the lookout. Your five physical senses cannot tell you anything about your being. They can't report any news that can possibly affect your being. Your being is something that is timeless, formless. It has always been and always will be, and it cannot be touched by anything, whether sickness, accident, hurt, pain, frustration, hope, joy. Nothing can affect it, whether negative or positive. Your being is a constant, and all you have to do to experience that, even with your five physical senses, yes, your five physical senses can actually confirm your being's existence, but you must put them in proper perspective. You must stay plugged in to being instead of the other way around. Don't be plugged into your five physical senses. Be plugged into being, and then you will experience that constant state of peace. Neither great nor terrible. Just peace, joy, purity. And that is what your being has to offer. And one more awesome element about being plugged into being, you are aware of everyone else's being as well. It's not just you that has that constant state of peace and joy, but everybody else around you. Now, your five physical senses may disagree with you on that. But again, stay plugged into being, not your five physical senses. What is your priority? Do you want to stay in tune to your five physical senses and what they suggest to you as reality? Or do you want to stay plugged into being and what it suggests to you as reality? It's all up to you. What do you want to believe? And what picture do you want to put forth into your world? Because your world that the five physical senses report on can match the peace that emanates from your being. But you actually have to be plugged into that being in order for that peace to carry over to your five physical senses. Don't go the other way around, because then your being will feel as if it's on that perpetual roller coaster ride. But it's not. It never was, and it never will be. No matter what's going on in your life, no matter how your physical senses are reporting to you, you stay tuned into your being, your truth, and nothing can sway you. have a wonderful kick butt day. We'll see you next time.